Hello everyone, welcome back to Civil Engineering Academy. My name is Marina and today I'm going to be solving a problem for your PE transportation exam. This problem is about traffic capacity. There are a bunch of equations and exhibits that we're going to have to reference on this problem, and they're all going to be finding our highway capacity manual. Unfortunately, these equations are not available in our NCES reference handbook, so keep that in mind. Whenever you have this type of problem, we need to use our highway capacity manual. So let's go ahead and dive into this problem. The problem states like this. The California Department of Transportation is conducting a traffic study to determine the operating conditions for an uninterrupted divided multi-lane highway segment in level terrain with three lanes in each direction. Given the data below, the level of service is most nearly. Okay, so I'm gonna break this problem down into five main steps. The first step is going to be to calculate our free flow speed. And for that, we're gonna be looking at our highway capacity manual on chapter 12. And we're gonna be looking at equation 12-3 for multi-lane highway segments. And the equation is our free flow speed equals our base free flow speed that was given minus an adjustment factor for the lane width minus an adjustment factor for the total lateral clearance minus an adjustment factor for the median type minus an adjustment factor for access point density. And so let's take a closer look into this equation. Here we have our base free flow speed that was given. This is 60 miles per hour. And from this value, we are subtracting four other values. These are reduction factors. And for each one of these adjustment factors or reduction factors, we're going to be looking at a different exhibit on our highway capacity manual. And I'm going to be listing these exhibits for you here on the corner. So for our F sub LW, we're going to be looking at exhibit 12-20. For our FTLC, we're going to be looking at exhibit 12-22. For our F sub M, we're going to be looking at exhibit 12-23. And for our F sub A, we're going to be looking at exhibit 12-24. So let's go ahead and do the math. So our free flow speed is going to be equal 60 minus our adjustment factor for the lane width. And if we look here in the data, we have a lane width of 11.5 feet. And if we look at our exhibit 12-20, we're going to find out that this is 1.9 minus our adjustment factor for the total lateral clearance. We have a total lateral clearance of 8 feet. And if we look at exhibit 12-22, we're going to see that this is 0.9 minus our adjustment factor for the median type, and the median type is here. This is a divided multi-lane highway segment. So for divided multi-lane highway segment or multi-lane highway segment, this is zero minus our adjustment factor for the access point density. So we have 20 access points per mile. And if we look at our exhibit 12-24, we're gonna see that this is 5. So let's do the math. Our FFS equals 52.2 miles per hour. Our second step is to estimate capacity. So estimate capacity. And for that, we're going to also look in our highway capacity manual, chapter 12, equation 12-7 for multi-lane highway segments. And the equation is capacity equals 1,900 plus 20 multiplied by our free flow speed minus 45. So our capacity is going to be 1,900 plus 20 times 52.2 minus 45. And this is 2,044 passenger car per hour per lane. Moving to our third step, we're going to now estimate the demand flow rate. And for that, we're going to be using equation 12-9 and equation 12-10. So equation 12-9 says that our V sub P, our demand flow rate, is equal our V, the demand that was given, divided by our peak, our factor, times the number of lanes in one direction, times an adjustment factor for heavy vehicles. So we have this value. This is 2,400. We have our peak hour factor, this is 0.75. Our number of lanes in one direction is 3. And we need to calculate our F sub HV, which is our adjustment factor for heavy vehicles. And for that, we're going to be using the equation 12-10, which is 1 divided by 1 plus P sub T, which is the proportion of trucks. Times our passenger car equivalent of one heavy vehicle in the traffic stream, which is our E sub T minus 1. So this was given, this is 10%, so 0.1. The E sub T, we're going to look at exhibit 12-5. So let's go ahead and plug in this value. So this is going to be 1 divided by 1 plus 0.1 times 2 minus 1. And we're going to see that this is going to be approximately 0.9. Okay, so now the next step is to calculate our volume flow rate. So I'm going to do this on the side. So our V sub P is going to be equal our demand. So 2,400 divided by our peak hour factor, 0.75, times the number of lanes in one direction, 3, times our adjustment factor for heavy vehicles, so 0.90. And this is going to give us a volume flow rate of 1,185.18 passenger car per hour per lane. So now we're going to move to our fourth step, which is to check for level of service F. So whenever our volume flow rate is greater than our capacity, we can automatically conclude that our level of service is equal F. In this case, we have estimated that our volume flow rate is equal 1,185.18 passenger car per hour per lane. And we calculated that our capacity is equal 2,044 passenger car per hour per lane. So we do not fall into this category because our capacity is greater than our volume flow rate. So we need to go ahead and move to our step 5, which is to estimate the speed and density. So for that, we're going to be looking at equation 12-11 that says that our density is equal to our volume flow rate divided by our mean speed, S. And for our mean speed, so for S, we're going to look at exhibit 12-15, and we're going to see that our breakpoint for multi-lane highway segments is constant. At 1,400 passenger car per hour per lane. And since our volume flow rate, our VSUP, is less than our breakpoint, we can assume that our mean speed is equal our free flow speed. So let's go ahead and input these values into the density equation. So we're going to have that our density is equal our V sub P divided by S. So we're going to input this value. So 1185.18 divided by 52.2. And then we're going to see that this is approximately 23 passenger car per mile per lane. And we can finally look at exhibit 12-15, and we're going to see that our level of service is equal C. This concludes this exercise. I hope you learned a lot, and I see you next time.